Good evening. Japanese Canadians will remember this as the day when Canada finally moved to right a wrong committed against them four decades ago. It was during the Second World War. Thousands of people were forced into internment camps simply because they were of Japanese descent. They've been waiting ever since for official acknowledgement of the injustice, and today they got it. An apology from the Prime Minister and compensation for their losses. Former internees call it a settlement that heals. Wendy Mesley begins our coverage in Ottawa.
I speak for members on all sides of the House today in offering to Japanese Canadians the formal and sincere apology.
It was the apology Japanese Canadians had waited more than 40 years to hear. In the gallery, they stood and cheered. NDP leader Ed Broadbent, whose first wife's family had been interned, was overcome by emotion as he read from a novel about life in the camps.
I cannot bear the memory. There are some nightmares from which there is no waking.
This was the nightmare. In 1942, several months after the Japanese attacked Pearl Harbor, 22,000 Japanese Canadians were sent to camps in northern British Columbia. Their homes and their livelihoods were taken away. Their families were torn apart. Not one was ever charged with an act of disloyalty.
Hi, how are you?
Brian Mulroney promised justice in the 1984 election campaign, but for 4 years, all his government offered was an apology and a fund for the Japanese community, no money for individuals. Then last month, the White House offered Japanese Americans, interned there, compensation. Today, the Canadian government did the same.
Offer symbolic redress payment of $21,000.
All the survivors of the camps, about 13,000, will be eligible for $21,000 each. Those convicted for refusing to go to the camps will have their names cleared. $12 million will go to a Japanese community fund. Another $24 million will go to create a Canadian Race Relations Foundation to make sure this kind of discrimination never happens again. The project will cost almost $300 million, and it came just in time for the election call expected this fall.
So if it happens today, I don't feel any guilt of whether we're being used, because it's something that we've struggled for.
It was an emotional day for everyone involved, for the Japanese Canadians and for the politicians.
Today is a historic landmark, not only for our community, but for the whole human rights issue. And thank you.
Wendy Mesley, CBC News, Ottawa.
The internment camps are the events of 40 years ago, but Masui Takashira says she has never been able to forget. She and her husband lost everything they had, a business, property, all the family's heirlooms. Her husband is one of the 9,000 internees who died before they could see today, but she knows he would be happy.
Until he died, he never could forget. He brought the document on the table every day, you know, how much he lost.
Japanese Canadians across the country reacted the same way. Francisco Miki in Winnipeg, watching her two sons, Art and Roy, negotiate this deal with the federal government, is the best way the nightmare could end.
I'm so happy that my children were, you know, fighting for it.
Most of the Japanese Canadian internees still live in British Columbia. They came back to this area after they were freed from the camps and started over. This, they say, is what they wanted from the government. The money recognizes that each of them had something stolen. The apology means they can be proud of their past.
We were so tenuous about speaking to the media or speaking to anybody about ourselves as Japanese, of Japanese ancestry. We were ashamed of it. We tried to hide from it. And now I think we're proud of it.
Charles Kadota is one of the early fighters for redress. He always knew he wasn't the enemy.
We're living in a democracy. The redress issue was not an issue of money. It was an issue of justice, of human rights, of citizenship.
No one here pretends that $21,000 each will make up for the millions that were lost, or that an apology will make up to 7 hard years in the Kootenays. What they will do, the internees say, is prove to everybody that Japanese Canadians were good Canadians all along. Karen Webb, CBC News, Vancouver.